Alrighty, hey guys, this is Peter from Techno Cocktail, and today I'm going to be showing you the tutorial on how to install Obisi plus 1.7. This is made by Lawrence, and we'll get right into it. First of all, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to download Mod Loader and Obisi plus 1.7. So just unzip both of those. Now, just what you're going to want to do, is you're going to want to go to your Minecraft file. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to your name. This is on Mac. You want to go to your name. Then you want to go to Library, Application Support, Minecraft, Bin, and you'll see Minecraft.jar. Now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to open this with an archive utility. This is going to unzip it for you. Now what you can do is you can get rid of this Minecraft.jar. I've already got a backup on my desktop. What you should do, I believe, is you should back it up. Now select the folder and press enter and type in .jar at the end of the name. It's going to ask you if you want to add the extension .jar. Just say yes. Double click the folder and go and move this to the side. You're going to want to open Mod Loader. What you're going to want to do then is you're going to want to select everything by pressing Command A, then pressing Command C to copy everything. Just to make sure that you've copied it, right click and left click to copy. Then you're going to want to paste everything by pressing Command and B into the Minecraft.jar folder. When it asks you, do you want to replace a class, you automatically just say apply to all and replace. Once that is complete, you're going to want to delete and close the Mod Loader folder. Inside your Minecraft.jar, there will be a folder called meta.inf. You require to get rid of this. If you don't get rid of this, your Minecraft shall not start up. Now you're going to want to open Obisi plus 1.7. What you're going to want to do now is you're just going to want to press Command A, Command C, go into your Minecraft.jar folder, and press Command V, and that's it. You're completely done. Now I'm just going to quickly edit my modding world so I can show you how to make the items, and I'll be right back. Okay, so our main ingredients today are going to be gold, iron, obsidian, glass, redstone, and a stick. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to open our inventory, since these are all craftable in our inventory, and we're going to want to take our obsidian, and we're going to want to place redstone to the right of it. Now, once that's done, you get magical obsidian. And we make tons of this, since this is the main ingredient of most of our things. So firstly, to stick with the redstone, we can make a teleport block. Just put everything in my inventory, there we go. This teleport block, it will move your X-axis or Y-axis, something like that. Obsidian dust, this is another material. And we can also make a launch pad, which is magical obsidian and a piece of gold above it. We can make a conveyor belt, which is just a piece of gold to the right of magical obsidian. We can make a trap block, which is iron to the right of magic obsidian. We can also... We can make obsidian plus dust and stick, make a force rod, there's 30 of them. A new thing in the new one is magical obsidian and glass. Let me just find the correct comp. Ah, there we go. This gives you obsidian glass. And that's all the materials, really. So let me show what each and every one of them do. that principle. Okay. So we've got our launch pad, our video block, our conveyor belt, and our track block. Okay, all of these have a different function. The launch pad was one of our first ones. As you can see, it doesn't do much but push you up. Now, as you can hear, once you left click it, it makes a noise. And after a while, it goes to a different sound, meaning it resets. Basically, what this means is every time you left click on it, it's going to send you higher and higher and higher and higher and higher until you hear the other sound. Like that. Now the other block we have is the camera teleport block. Basically what this block does is it moves your camera a few blocks forward. To get off of this block, right? To get off of this block, you just move out of the way. Now what else you've got here is a conveyor block. Basically what the conveyor block does is it feeds you along certain areas. I don't know why it's not working well. And what you've also got is the trap block. This basically reverses your movement, this allowing you to get out. You've also got this nifty little tool that I'm using right now, which allows you to fly. Now, just a little pre-use warning before you people start thinking, oh, if I fall down, it's going to be fine. Don't. Even if you are floating one block above the floor, you will not get it to work properly. It will kill you. This is what we are working on right now. Now, this is also a new addition. This is obsidian glass. Basically, what obsidian glass does is it is a see-through object which doesn't allow light to it. And that's basically it. There is a new object available if you people are interested in it. It is just obsidian plus dust in your inventory, which makes obsidian plus magical controller rune. Basically, what these do is they are not used yet. They will be used soon on a new object, which me and Lawrence are working on right now. And just to give you a little sneak peek, it's gonna be like a dispenser. Anyway, so this was my video. Please rate, subscribe, whatever, do whatever you people do on YouTube. And thanks for watching. See you later. Bye.